Alright, here I am starting a new video. It's my Cuisinart sandwich maker machine. Yay for product placement. Excuse me. Cuisinart sandwich grill. I'm heating it up a little bit right now, but I tend to make recipes my own way, so I don't always go by whatever the lights on the top of that say. I was having an idea for some fried ravioli, and I'm a cheese person. I don't so much care about sauce or gravy, as the Italians call it. Unless you're having roast beef, and then it's au jus. But that's not the point. So y'all know what I look like. You've seen me before. I've been in other videos. And I just thought I would see how this goes. Had an idea in my head. I've got the grill. I've got ingredients. We have some cheese. We have some ravioli that's pre-cooked from last night. Actually, it was some kind of a steamed version that came out pretty well. So, the sandwich maker should be a little warm right now, which is exactly what I'm going for. And, the raviolis are about an inch square, so we're gonna... There's one. And here's another one. Basically, the idea is to have little ravioli sandwiches, so... Bear with me, because this is all handheld, and, so it's a little tricky to keep this camera steady, but it's the best way to shoot and pan and stuff. The grill's not overly hot, which is fine because the ravioli from last night are sticking together to each other really well. So you can hear them popping around. And this is just a fun thing of taking leftovers and getting them reused rather than wasting stuff. So, pile of cheese, more cheese. I know, the ravioli already have cheese in them. They don't have meat in them, because I'm a cheese person. I mean, I will eat meat ravioli, but I'll eat anything, pretty much. Not coconuts, though, or anchovies. Or anything that's not cooked, usually. Canned tuna is about the only exception. The cheese is already starting to melt, so I kind of have time working against me, which, again, is why I didn't wait until the lights on the thing changed to green. That means go ahead. When I put down the top, the lid's gonna compress these and shape them, the ravioli, into what it thinks are little triangles. And usually that's how they come out, so I'm probably gonna have bits that get cut off. That'll be kind of interesting. I'm about half done here with my little ravioli sandwiches. Just taking a little extra strength to peel them off each other in the bag and one-handed. So, I don't really plan ahead for this recipe. Oh, there we go. Oh, I gotta do two more reps. I'm not too worried about burning anything because I don't care how long I cook cheese for, I don't mind burning it. Cheese is fun. So, here we go. Alright. The lid locks into place, and basically have a bunch of filler time while I'm waiting for this to cook. I don't feel like editing anything together, so I'm getting it done in real time. I have a few ravioli left, so we can go ahead and pop those in the microwave. That might be a little more useful. Basically, I think I'm gonna trying to finagle these apart. It's really not easy. Okay. Alright, so yes, my household is not an expensive household. We eat off your plates here all the time. I'm gonna take about half the cheese off of this plate and put it on these guys because cheese is good. So, I'll take a little more cheese. Oops. And also, I have out this store brand of three cheeses. It's Parmesan Romano and Asiago. So, it really isn't the best distance for this camera. But, anyways, while I've already got those waiting, why not have even more cheese? So, a little bit of that. I'll probably use it again later. And off we go. Don't need to really light my way. I can actually see where the microwave is. Put it on in there. And then... 35, why not? Give it an extra 5 seconds. Was gonna wait. No, I'm not. This microwave's so old that it doesn't have a rotator. Who cares? Every animal in the house is down here right now. I brought the birds out to play. I brought the cats down to play. They pretty much follow me everywhere anyways. But they're all being quiet. The birds are being quiet because they're not in their cages, so that generally makes them be quiet. The cats are not whining because they've had treats already, so... And being cats, they don't speak English. They have no idea I just said treats. Twice. Alright, so... Yay, that melted perfectly. A little more of the pre-grated stuff. Raviolis are just about done. Let's say we pop them and check it. Ooh yeah, just about done. I don't mind the browning, that's fine. That just means it'll be crunchy. And I still can add some sort of gravy sauce, what have you, to them if I want. You can see over here where there's a little bit of ravioli sticking out. It doesn't matter, it'll taste fine. I'm going to go ahead and get a fork. This is a non-stick type of machine, so yes, I am using a metal item on it, but it's a non-stick machine, so everything kind of just falls off of it. So let's see. The end of the story. Yeah, looks good to me. So we're going to offload those. Unplug this. Sorry about the bad painting. Oh yeah, they're sticking together really well, so. Good eats. I am kind of surprised. This kind of has a shape that it gives it, but the rest of it doesn't. So, gotta get, there we go. Gotta get the squares off. And of course, doing it one-handed isn't ideal. So basically, it smells like mac and cheese, but it's ravioli, so that makes it even better. And anything you do to mac and cheese, you can do to ravioli and cheese. I mean, it's the exact same stuff. And for the final garnishings, a little more cheese. A little more cheese for the video. A little more cheese. The birds are peeping. And then I put a little more cheese on here. And that's it, the end. I gotta eat. Hope you enjoyed my video. Bye.